You guys see what I deal with on a daily basis? You don't even know. You don't even know. Are you done? Oh, he's gonna take you out. See? That's what you get. Good boy, Diesel.
Over the arms, not the fingers, Diesel. Good luck, Claire.
Thanks, Corey. Anyway, all right, guys. Today we're gonna talk about automotive shampoo, soap, car wash, whatever you guys wanna call it. I know there's a million names out there for it, but you know, a lot of people know what it does, but they don't know how it does it or the chemistry behind it. So that's what we're gonna talk about today. All right, so automotive shampoo or soap, whatever you wanna call it, is made up mostly of something called surfactants. And what a surfactant is a two-part molecule, and one side loves water and one side loves dirt. So when you put the soap on your car, this two-part molecule goes on a little mission, and it goes and looks for dirt, and then it finds it, and once it seeks out that dirt and grabs hold of it, the water-loving part suspends that dirt, you know, above the surface of your paint, so then it can just be washed away, which is pretty cool. But another cool thing is that there are a bunch of different kinds of surfactants, and we're gonna go over those for you guys. So prepare to hear a bunch of random words that you're probably not gonna remember in like 2 minutes, but I mean, we're gonna toss them at you anyway and see what happens. So the first surfactant is called an anionic surfactant, and that is the most well-known one, if that's a thing, and it's the first one that came, you know, widely commercially available, and it's good at just general cleaning, and it's also good at foaming up, so that's why you see your soap, you know, get foamy when you use it or spray some water into the bucket. The next surfactant that you're gonna sometimes see in soap is actually called a cationic surfactant. Yeah. So that one actually can leave different films on your paint, which is actually pretty cool. And a common one is like an anti-static film. And you might not really notice those or feel those, but they are on your car. And what that anti-static film does is keeps, I don't know if it would necessarily keep dirt away, but it makes it less likely to sit and cling to your paint because there's not that static charge for stuff to come and cling to. You know what I'm saying? So our next surfactant is a non-ionic surfactant, and these are kind of the heavy lifters of the surfactant world. And when you get like tar and greasy properties, like anything on your paint, you know, when you're like washing it and you have a little speck that's like this big, and then it like somehow turns into a big smudge, and then you're really irritated and you just try and wash off more and it just doesn't want to come off, you're probably going to want more of these surfactants in your soap because they are the ones that do the most work. They're the ones that get rid of that dirt, that grime, and you know, make your day better. And also, you know those really, really, really annoying hard water spots that you get? They're also tolerant of that, so if your soap has a lot of non-ionic surfactants in it, you're really not gonna have to worry about that as much as far as the soap goes. But do not forget to dry your car off right away after you rinse it off, because that soap's not gonna help with those water spots. All right, you guys, we're gonna talk about our last surfactant here. Hopefully you haven't fallen asleep quite yet from all this chemistry fancy science talk, but anyway, it's called the amphoteric surfactant, and this surfactant doesn't really know what it wants to be all the time. It can either be a So this can be either an anionic or a cationic surfactant. So it can either, you know, boost the foaming power of the soap, or it can boost the cleaning power of the soap. So it's kind of cool. So it kind of just is formulated to go one way or the other. So it's just kind of the little guy behind these main surfactants, just kind of pushing them along and helping them do their job better. All right, you guys, so we're gonna do a plug here. I know you saw this coming, but we do have two soaps available on our site, www.fitmentindustries.com, and there's a dog over there, so I'm a little distracted, but I'm gonna keep going for you guys. So the first soap that we have is our Premier Vehicle Wash. And this is a great soap, has great cleaning properties. It also is very safe for your paint. So if you have wax on your car or anything like that that you don't want to come off, it's not gonna take it off, because there are some harsh soaps out there that will take that off, including dish soap. Don't use dish soap on your car, just don't. And also, there's also some wax properties in here, so that's pretty cool. It will kind of help upkeep your wax layer if you have it on your car. Did you hear that goose? Holy sh-. They hiss and they get weird little black okay, I have like, I don't even want to talk about it. I had a really bad time in a marsh once. I got attacked by a goose because I wanted to pet it. All right, for all you guys that like using foam cannons and maybe like those, you know, Instagram scene points, this one's probably for you. This is our soap, but it's just made and formulated for foam cannons. So, you know, it does the thing. It foams up a lot, and it is safe for paint, again, just like our other one. And it does have wax properties in it too, so it is still gonna help upkeep your layer of wax. All right, you guys, so that's all we have for today. Don't forget to check out our site at www.fitmentindustries.com for all your wheel, tire, suspension needs, along with some cool like car care and apparel. Yeah, that's pretty cool. And don't forget to add your car to the gallery and hit that subscribe button. But we will see you next time. Peace.